Alhaji Nuhu Sanusi, the Emir of Dutse, Jigawa State in Northwest Nigeria, has urged the federal government to give women loans at 4 or 5% interest rates to improve their economic well-being. The Emir gave the advice at the opening of a three-day conference on integration of gender and sustainable development goals perspective in Nigeria's public-private partnerships in Abuja.
Women represent more than 50% of our population, and yet they are the underdogs. They represent maybe 10% or 3% of the economy, which is definitely unacceptable. What is happening now, the mainstream banks, women don't have the collateral to go and borrow, and they don't have the educational capacity to fill their requirements, tax clearance, so many other requirements that are unnecessary for women and unnecessary really for a small-scale operator. I have made challenges. I wish Central Bank is here today. No? Nobody is here from Central Bank. They keep posting that they have supported particularly women in improving their economic well-being, and I am yet to be convinced that they have really helped women. And I want, if there is anybody from Central Bank here, I want to challenge you to tell us how much money have you expended to small-scale women or gender-sensitive programs. They give it to a mainstream bank at 2%. The mainstream bank may be, I'm sorry, African Development Bank this year. Then they give it to, they will give it to a big entrepreneur or whatever, not a woman. They will give them at 18%. Tell me, if you don't, unless you are doing cocaine or something, there's no way you can borrow money in this country, either for agriculture, or industry, or whatever, and be able to pay at 18%. There's no way. This is a fact. So if we really want to help gender, really want to improve, we are serious in doing this, we will have to give women 5% or 4% interest in their projects.
Mrs. Aisha Buhari, the First Lady, represented by Dr. Hajusani, Senior Special Assistant Administration to the wife of the President, while delivering the keynote address, said the integration of gender perspectives in infrastructure, especially in public-private partnerships design and implementation, will greatly address many gaps in the nation's infrastructure delivery.
This event also symbolizes the premium we place on closing the gender gap, and I will be delighted to learn that this gathering of eminent women leaders, professionals, heads of agencies, and indeed all Nigerians will support the critical integration processes going forward. We must promote imbibe gender responsive infrastructure that supports the sustainable development goals to achieve a better and more sustainable future for all.
Mr. Chidi Izua, the country director, Infrastructure Concession Regulatory Commission, has this to say.
It is assumed that women and men will automatically benefit from new infrastructure without due acknowledgement to the full range of social and economic impacts, both beneficial and negative. Too often, the positive outcomes experienced by women through infrastructure projects have been unintended and unplanned.
For his part, Mr. Ebrimafal, Senior Country Director, Nigeria, African Development Bank, said as of 2018, the continent had an infrastructure gap of $130 to $180 billion, with an annual financing gap of $60 to $80 billion.
Estimates in 2018 puts this number at around $130 to $180 billion, with an annual financing gap of somewhere around $60 to $80 billion. So these are very large numbers. And what is clear is that the fiscal space that's available to our governments to fill this gap is very small. So we need to find innovative mechanisms, and the private sector needs to be deeply involved in making sure that the deficit gap is addressed in the continent.